Thank you. reflections of our Reginald. The very hopelessness of our love is a bond that binds us together.
Jealousy is merged with misery, and the very cynosure of our eyes and hearts remains icy and sensible. What have we to strive for?
The love of maidens is to him as interesting as the taxes.
Would that it were! He pays his taxes.
And cherishes the receipts.
Happy receipts.
Fools!
I beg your pardon?
Fools and blind. The man loves, wildly loves.
But whom?
None of us. No, none of us. His weird fancy has lighted for the nuts on Patience, the village milkmaid.
On Patience? Oh, it cannot be.
But yesterday I caught him in her den, eating fresh butter off a tablespoon. Today he is not well.
Oh. But Patience boasts that she has never loved, that love is to her a sealed book. Oh, he cannot be serious.
Tis a fleeting fancy. Twill quickly wear away. Oh, Reginald, if you but knew what a wealth of golden love was stored up for you in this rugged old bosom of mine, the days of triumph would be short indeed.
She is by the gate, for she is by the gate, and the law.
indigestion. It is not indigestion. It is aesthetic transfiguration. Enough of babble. Come.
But stay! I have some news for you. The 35th Dragoon Guards have halted in the village and are even now on their way to this very spot.
The 35th Dragoon Guards. They are fleshly men.
Our fool habit.
We care nothing for Dragoon Guards.
But bless me, you were all engaged to them a year ago.
A year ago.
My poor child. You don't understand these things. A year ago, they were all very well in our eyes. But since then, our perceptions have been exalted. Our tastes etherealized. Come. It is time to lift up our voices in morning carol to our Reginald. Let us to his door.
Thank you. once again at the scene of our former triumphs. Where's the Duke?
Here I am.
Go, cheer up, don't give way.
Oh, for that, I'm as cheerful as a poor devil can be expected to be, who has the misfortune of being a duke. With 1,000 a day.
Most men would envy you.
Envy me? Tell me, Major, are you fond of toffee?
Very.
We are all fond of toffee. We are!
Yes, and toffee in moderation is a capital thing. But to live on toffee, toffee for breakfast, toffee for dinner, toffee for tea. Suppose you cared for nothing but toffee, and you would consider yourself insulted if anything but toffee were offered to you. How would you like that?
I can quite believe that even in those circumstances, even toffee would become monotonous.
For toffee, read flattery, adulation, and abject deference, carried to such a pitch that I began at last to think that man was born bent at an angle of 45 degrees. Great heavens, what is there to adulate in me? Am I particularly intelligent?
No!
Or remarkably studious?
No!
Or excruciatingly witty?
No!
Or unusually accomplished?
No!
Or exceptionally virtuous?
You're about as commonplace a young man as I ever saw.
You are!
Exactly! That's it exactly. It describes me to a T. Thank you all very much. Well, I couldn't stand any longer, so I decided to join the second-class cavalry regiment. And the army thought I might be occasionally snubbed, perhaps even bullied, who knows? The thought was rapture, and here I am.
Yes, and here are the ladies.
Ah. But who is the gentleman with the long hair?
I don't know.
He seems popular.
He does seem popular.
Treatment for a military man. literary man who despises dinner play. I hear plainly all they say, 20 loves have been in vain.
Here's plainly all they say, 20 loves have been in vain.
Amorous polycynth yearns for the aloe fate with rapturous thrills. How can he take the thrones, knowing, as he well knows, that they are only uncompounded pills? Is it, and can it be, nature hath this decree? Nothing poetic in the world shall dwell? Or that in all her works something poetic lurks, even in colocynth and calomel? I cannot tell!
How purely fragrant! How earnestly precious!
Well, it seems to me to be nonsense.
Nonsense, yes, perhaps. But oh, what precious nonsense!
This is all very well, but you seem to forget that you are engaged to us.
It can never be. You are not imperial. You are not Della Pruskin. You are not even early English.
Be early English, ere it be too late.
Red and yellow. Primary colours. Oh, South Kensington.
We didn't design our uniforms. But I don't see how they could be improved.
You wouldn't. Still, there is a cobwebby green velvet with a tender bloom of cold gravy, which made Florentine 14th century and trimmed with Venetian leather and Spanish altarpiece and surmounted with something Japanese. Matters not what. Will at least be early English. Come, maids.
Gentlemen, this is an insult to the British uniform.
A uniform that has been as successful in the courts of Venus as on the fields of Mars. When I first put this uniform on, I said as I looked in the glass, it's one to a million that any civilian my figure and form will surpass. Gold lace has a charm for the fair, and I'm very glad to be spare. Well, I love a head, a heart, a head, a eloquent everywhere. A fact that I counted upon when I first put this uniform on. They will see that I'm pretty gold laced in a uniform handsome and chaste. While a long tent and a long hair aesthetics are very much more to their taste. Which I never counted upon when I first put this uniform on.
Thank you.
not belike me. Lank limbs and haggard cheeks do not delight me. I do not care for dirty things by any means. I do not long for other things as Japanese. I am not fond of ethnic tattoos and stained glass attitudes. In short, my believism's affectation. It's born of a morbid love for admiration. If you ain't for to shine in the heights that you climb as a man of culture, well, you must get above the germs of the transcendental terms and plot them everywhere. You must delight on dates and discourse in other places of your complicated state of mind. The thing doesn't matter if it's in the enchantment of a transcendental mind. And everyone will say, as he walked up this mystic way, if this young man expresses himself in terms too deep for me, why, what a very singularly deep young man this deep young man must be. Be the eloquent claims of the very god of death, which have long since passed away, and convince him if you can that the rain could be down, but has helped his palm this day. Oh, of course he must be what an expression new, and if that is true and mean, for I'll stop short in the cultivated cult of the young Prince Josephine. And everyone will say, as you walk your mystic way, if that's not good enough for him, which is good enough for me, why, what a very cultivated kind of youth this kind of youth must be. Then a sentimental passion of veritable fashion must excite your lady's name. And affection on a plate full of bashful young potato will not do French be. Though the fearlessness we jostle will rank us in the parcel in the high aesthetic band. If you walk on Piccadilly with a puppy on a lily in your medieval house. And everyone will say, as he walks the flowery way, if he's content with his vegetable love, it certainly not suits me. Why, what a most particularly pure young man this pure young man must be. Casual spectator would imagine. You haven't ever seen me frolicsome.
confidence. Though you despise me, I am exceedingly popular with the other young ladies.
I only ask that you believe me and never renew the subject.
Certainly. Broken hearted and desolate I go. Oh, to be wafted away from this black Aceldama of sorrow, where the dust of an earthy today is the earth of a dusty tomorrow. It is a little thing of my own. I call it heart foam. I shall publish it. Farewell, patience, farewell.
Oh, what does it all mean? Why does he love me? Why does he expect me to love him? He's not a relation.
Distinguished from insanity. Oh, blind child. Oh, pretty maiden, will you marry me? I'm hopeful, will obey me. I may say at once, I'm a man of property. They will obey me all. Money, I despise it. Many people prize it. Changed me?
15 years? What do you mean?
Have you forgotten the friend of your youth? Your Archibald, your little playfellow? Oh, Kronos! Kronos, this is too bad of you! Stouter than I was.
Have you improved?
Yes, Patience, I am very beautiful.
Surely that doesn't make you unhappy.
Yes, Patience, gifted as I am with a beauty which probably has not its rival on this earth. I am nevertheless completely and utterly miserable.
Oh, but why?
My child love for you has never faded. Consider then the horror of my situation. When I tell you it is my hideous destiny to be madly loved at first sight by every woman I come across. These gifts, irksome as they are, were given to me for the enjoyment and delectation of my fellow creatures.
Then you two are poets?
Yes. I am the apostle of simplicity. I am called Archibald the All Right. Not strange. I have loved you with a Florentine 14th century frenzy for 15 years.
Powers I never thought of that.
between me and my happiness.
Oh, if you were a thought less beautiful than you are.
Would that I were, but candor compels me to admit that I'm not.
Our duty is clear. We must part, and forever.
Oh, misery! And yet, I cannot question the propriety of your statement. Farewell, patience.
But stay!
Yes, patience?
Although I may not love you, for you are perfection, there's nothing to prevent your loving me. I am plain, homely, unattractive.
Why, that's true!
are bad. By the advice of my solicitor, in aid of a deserving I put myself up to be around the bar.
Yeah.
draw the first.
Thank you.
and poetic.